The whole point is to fill up the big rig, and they have these posters here also, so you can start dropping off your donations here at Belle Isle City Hall starting at 8 o'clock this morning. And the man in charge of all of this, Randy, you're helping out organizing everything. So talk about why you guys decided to do this.
Yeah, exactly right. And we're actually inside Longwood Elementary School. This is a brand new classroom, very nice. I just spoke with the victim, and he tells me that a Hispanic man pointed a gun to his head and told him not to move or else he will kill him. Well, we know that the spokesperson for the Pulse nightclub was telling us that the owner is actively searching for a new. Deborah St. Charles is charged with aggravated manslaughter. Police say that she forgot that three-year-old boy inside the van, and temperatures got as high as 144 degrees. This is the woman DCF says wasn't even approved to be a daycare driver. According to police, Deborah St. Charles picked up three-year-old Miles Hill Monday morning. Her first stop, the Little Miracles Academy on Colonial. Police say she dropped off some kids in her van, and little Miles was supposed to get off too, but never did. Police say she admitted not doing a head count.
That was a child. How you not gonna check? That was an innocent child. She just needed to get what she deserved.
Then she got in the van and drove to the other daycare location on Plymouth. Officers say she got her things from the floor of the van, locked it, and went inside the daycare, never checking to see if anyone was still inside. Monday night, three-year-old Miles Hill was discovered dead inside the van.
It is believed that Miles was in the van, the hot van, all day long since 9 a.m. This is your worst nightmare come true.
2 days later, the state issued emergency suspensions at both daycare locations. Orlando police say this is the fifth death in the state this year involving a child left in a hot vehicle. As St. Charles waits for her fate, a community continues to mourn for little Miles.
But I send the condolences out to the mother from mother. I feel your pain and I'm sorry for you.
Boy.
And St. Charles is expected to face a judge around 9 o'clock this morning, so we'll let you know what happens. For now, reporting live here outside the jail, Jackie Orozco, Fox 35 News.
They say that there are 63 active hate groups in the state of Florida and more than a dozen right here in Central Florida. According to a new study by the Southern Poverty Law Center, which tracks hate groups and extremists in the U.S., the Sunshine State ranks second with the most active hate groups in the nation. In Central Florida, there are 14 hate groups, mostly in Orange County, but you can also find them in Seminole, Brevard, Sumter, and Alachua counties. Some of these groups include anti-immigrant, anti-LGBTQ, and the Ku Klux Klan. The study comes after a race riot in Charlottesville, Virginia, where a 32-year-old woman was killed. The rally was organized by white supremacist groups that took to the streets carrying Nazi and Confederate flags. The rally was held to protest the city's plan to remove a Confederate statue of Robert E. Lee. We caught up with Governor Rick Scott, who condemns these hate groups.
It's evil. I don't believe in it. It's disgusting that this stuff, that this would ever go on in our society. I hope it, I don't ever want it to happen in our country. I clearly don't want it to happen in my state.
According to the Southern Poverty Law Center, hate groups have been growing in huge numbers since 2015, and there's no stopping of it.
And the study also reported that across the country, there are more than 900 hate groups. For now, reporting live here in Orlando, Jackie Orozco, Fox 35 News.